I'm with Simon Cooper. Hello.
Hello.
Now, what have you got here at your exhibit today?
Well, our exhibit is really about a lot of maritime tradition and history. So we build these boats, which are called Irish curraghs, which are built with wood. But the outside is covered with a fabric, which is known as flax fabric.
Oh, right.
And flax is a plant which we've been growing in this country since the Bronze Age. But for the last 50 years, it hasn't been grown. So as a consequence, there's no flax industry. And we thought it was a good time to reintroduce the crop. So we're showing how it can be used in traditional ways, but how it can also be a part of a sustainable future.
Fantastic. What happens from when you harvest it?
Well, the plant, a lot of people will be familiar with seeing the yellow rape flowers. And also they will remember some very lovely blue fields, which you would see once in a while. And that's a plant called the linseed.
Right.
Now, linseed and flax are both the same species of plant, but the flax plant grows a lot taller. And from the flax plant, you will get fibre.
Right.
And this fibre can be then be spun and woven, and it makes very fine linen cloth.
Oh.
But it can also be used to make rope, canvas. It's a whole range of good. It's a really, really useful plant.
Okay.
In fact, its Latin name is Linum Usitissimus. I don't know if you can say that any better than I could.
Oh, we'll try.
Which does mean linen, most useful. So the Romans, the Latin translation is for the most useful plant.
Okay, brilliant. Well, can we see you in action doing a little bit?
When they were harvested, they were led out on the ground and they needed to get wet and dry to start basically rotting a little bit so that we can then release the fibre from inside the plant. So in there is the fibre.
Wow.
So all these tools are specific tools which are cottage industry tools which we've had to remake to process the flax. And this stage is actually called breaking, so you're breaking the outer stem. So it's sort of a crimping process. All these bits which are flying around are known as shive. It can be used for sort of horse bedding, that sort of thing. Although on a commercial scale, you would probably make it into a chipboard, a fibreboard.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got the broken fibre. If you feel that, you see it's already starting to feel a bit softer.
Yeah, that's amazing.
I mean, the fibres are still stuck together with pectins, so we've got to further separate these fibres, but we still want to keep it in its one long length.
Yeah.
So this is a bunch of broken flax fibres. We keep the root end and the branch end separate, and now we've got to start cleaning these and separating them a bit more. So we move on to this tool over here. All this waste stuff you see blowing around on the floor is called tow. And that could be made into ropes and a heavier canvas. The product which I'm working on now would be what can be woven into a finer linen. See, we've got a soft. It's getting softer and cleaner all the time. The next stages are called, this combing is referred to in linen making as hackling or heckling. So you're pulling the fibres apart and continually cleaning them and getting them straighter. This is the top end of the plant where the seed heads were. I mean, it's really, really sort of quite tangled at the moment. So you've just got to just carefully take the tops off. You really have to keep a good grip on this, otherwise it all becomes tangled and you lose too much. And you just continue this combing process. So you're gradually, the fibres are now starting to separate a bit as well. There's still some odd woody bits in there which are beginning to fall out. And you'll get hold of it again and I'm going to start cleaning the root end. I mean, that's it nearly at the stage where it's ready for spinning. So this we will spin on the traditional sort of spinning wheel. Yep. But to spin flax is a bit different to other fibres, because you spin it in an anti-clockwise direction, which is different to wool and other fibres because of the natural twist in the plant.
Oh, okay.
And it also has to be spun off at a distaff, because if you're not very careful, you'll start spinning this and the whole lot will go in one go. So you've got to spread it out around a cone, which is a very sort of, it's a very sort of old thing, the distaff, which most people think they're a flagpole, but that's actually what they originated from, stick which was made for spinning. Once you've spun the thread, you can start making it into a whole range of useful goods. I mean, here is what we've done with some of the rougher fibre, and this is the start of a fishing net. The top headline is the flax fibre. It's been spun, and it's been spun a few more times to make it into a rope, into a twine. And as you can see below, that there's the netting. I mean, that's more the use of the coarser fibre. Of course, flax fibre was very much a thing of sailcloth in the past. And of course, I think most people know of it as sort of high fashion. Now, we haven't been making weaving for very long. And so this is some of our fabric. See, that's been cleaned. You can see it's got a softness. If the sun was out, it's got a luster, which is a typical thing for flax.
Wow, that's really soft.
Yeah, that's gone quite nicer. And this is actually been dyed with oak bark, which is in marine terms is known as kutch, which is, it's not really to dye it. It's a way of preserving sailcloth when it gets wet. Mm-hmm. And it's really nice to use sort of a natural oak bark on a natural fabric.
That's brilliant.
So those are our uses of it. But the other thing with flax is, of course, you do get a seed from the seed pod. Most people will know that as linseed. And I mean, that particularly in recent years, flax seed, linseed are both the same thing, is a very good health food. It's got those applications. It can be made into paints, that type of, and resins. And one thing which we're working on is, this canoe here.
Yes.
Now, this is a combination. We're putting the whole plant back together. We've got wooden frames, which are some ash, local ash. There's some plywood in there, which we hope is from a sustainable forest. But the rest of it is made from the linseed, the flax plant again. The fibre is a woven from the stem, and the waterproofing is a new linseed-based resin. Right. So we're starting to make boats in a natural fashion again. There's a lot of interest in putting natural fibres into modern day composites. Mm. So, you know, we're hoping that there's going to be a real interest in this plant again.
Brilliant. Let's have a look at this canoe. That's it?
Yes, this boat actually is called an Irish Curragh. It's a very typical boat of the west coast of Ireland, and it's built of fabric on a wooden frame. And the wood, I built this boat about 5-6 years ago, and we were really lucky to get the timber from Westonbirt. So the top gunwales and all of the ribs and the, what we call the stringers, which are supporting the fabric, they're all made from a larch, which was sawn down here and sawn up locally.
Brilliant. And of course, the outside is all flax.
This is all flax, yeah, with a tar covering.
Wow.
And these boats are very much a seagoing boat. They were used for fishing, transport animals out to the islands. And I mean, their origins both go back many thousands of years. Originally, they would have been covered with a cowhide, but as weaving and fabric came on, people found it was easier to use the flax fabric, and they'd stay waterproof for longer with the tar on than with the lard or the butter, which they used to cover the cowhides with.
All right, brilliant.